Have you spoken to Jesse recently? I texted him yesterday to hear if he wanted to do a little update, but he couldn't do it yesterday. But he said, what about today? So we might get a little Jesse update. And boys, I am struggling a bit to what to do with all of this young boys coming in asking for help these days. I'm actually struggling a bit on what to do. There is so many, and the thing is, if I do that, if I start helping them, I can guarantee you it will be made an article in the Norwegian media. Muscle man makes young boys get into bodybuilding and the unhealthy fucking lifestyle of bodybuilding. Even though I'm just saying you should walk a little bit, eat, you should choose a little bit healthier food. Like, I'm not going to say anything else. You're going to made them eat protein powder. I'm like, oh god. That's what's going to happen. Twitch celebrity and TikToker starts getting recruiting young boys into the bodybuilding ever never ending circle of muscle building and everything that is bad is seen as bad in Norway. That's exactly what they're going to there's going to be some really bad fucking starts recruiting them at the age of 12. And I'm like, oh my god, recruited me. Mats, you're a grown ass fucking man, okay? You started working out. It's not bad. You're soon to be 30. That's different. I recruited you to train hard, Mats. Or if you go to media first, I'm not interested in being in the fucking Norwegian media. The only thing they're interested in is spreading hatred towards everyone, and I am not interested. I want to be on my Twitch channel. I want to be alone here with you guys. We can, that people that understand when I am ranting, they'll take it 100% seriously. We making jokes about things. There's Muslim are considered a microaggression. Good day, Infinite. When I am helping Jesse or other people that is struggling a bit, it's just out of pure that I want to see them having a better life. There's no, I'm not interested in them doing bodybuilding or anything. I know most people aren't interested in bodybuilding as a sport. It is just, I'm in a position after training for years that I know how easy it can be, if done the correct way, to lose some weight. Some people are struggling because they don't have the same knowledge. I have a big platform. I can give some advice. That's all.
If I may make a suggestion, make a general guide for people about how to start, what research they can do, what things to look into and what good practices are. Plans are specific to the person, you can't help everyone, but that guide could help them start.
That's a good idea, Duki. And that's actually a good idea. I can't help anyone. Maybe we should, as a community, write a little bit. Maybe I should set together a little group, me and a few others, and we should make a little document, a little guidance. Doesn't need to be anything insane fucking big book of how to, but just a little guide how to start up with some good advice in as well, like the advice I said yesterday, because we were reading an article from the Norwegian governmental sponsored news sources. Where it was, young boys down to 12 is trapped into fucking addicted to building muscle. That was the article, and I saw just, and they're watching TikTok, and that's where they get this shit from. We gathered comments from young accounts all over Norway. 200,000 comments. Them asking, and we contacted some of them. I just see this coming. We should just an easy little guide. And then therefore, some of the comments were, oh, how can I look like you? Was some of the comments, this is what's worrying them. And the advice I gave yesterday is that I said that it should be a life lesson. Never look at someone and say, I want to look like you because you can't look like anyone else. I think that is the best advice everyone needs to get. Many people who get well-known on social media often fall for the talk to media trap, think they will
commute
grow
advice,
bigger.
Nine. Chapter 1, eat less, move more, don't be a lazy bastard. The end.
Big Jim, thank you. That was a good one. Out of context to people not knowing who the fuck you are. Yes, Infinite, you are correct. And I can guarantee you, one thing. If I started helping a lot of people, the only thing media would see is me trying to get them into bodybuilding. There is no fucking way in this world that anyone would think that Knut just wants them to better themselves a little bit. So you would have to handpick people that actually was struggling so bad all the time. You could never help anyone that just looked normal. Because if you did, it would be seen as pushing them towards getting big and strong, which is seen as bad, right? I would have to handpick the absolute those who are like so obese that it's like obvious that this is only for helping them having a better lifestyle. Knut's bodybuilding cult, yeah. I think media will look at Muskelbunten first on TikTok. He also wanted media to look at him, I guess, but keep up the good work, Knut. Thank you. Yes, he's pushing a bit more to the Norwegian audience as well. And what did Bjørn say? I saw your comment. Knut, a good and general advice is that kids need to be physical active 60 minutes every day, like walking and just... Baby, I 100% agree with you. Don't worry, Knut, chat will deal with any bad press. We will protect you. The problem is, they just fucking turn off the comments. That's what they do, they just turn off the comment section. They write an article, people read the... They see the picture, probably a picture of me, and they read the topic. Pushing bodybuilding onto young boys in Norway. And a picture of me. Yes, and then the ball rolls. Twitch bodybuilder Knut are pushing teenagers to do bodybuilding. The youngest ones already only 13 years old. That's 100% what's going to be. I know, that is a big issue. Even if we just, because I am not interested in promoting or coaching for bodybuilding. I've said this. Because it's only seen as bad here in this country. Maybe if I moved to Texas, I could do that. But not in Norway, not in any fucking way. Will I start pushing any of that? Or even giving advice? Why is that seen as bad? I don't get it. I'll show you guys an example of a new article that someone posted on my Reddit. It was just, what's your thoughts about this, Knut, was the what they said. But I'll show you how it's seen. What does Knut think of the NRK article about kids getting addicted to extreme bodybuilding? Is what he wrote. Link to article. I will translate it into English so more of you can read. I'm not sure if is the text big enough. So when it is this red ones, this is text that I have copied from TikTok. What is the easiest method to lose fat? I'm 13 years old and hate my body. This is a question from a young boy on TikTok. The comment is one of several thousands that Norwegian children have left on videos of adult muscle men. The youngest comments are no more than 9 years old. Can you eat candy if you want to get bigger muscle? Can you convince mom to let me buy protein powder, please? Now NRK can document how the algorithm dragged children into a world of extreme training. I'm not sure if this is fucked up translation or whatever it is, but it doesn't matter. Who wants a fat boy? This is Samuel Vedeler. He's a perfectly normal 13-year-old. Before, he played both basketball and tennis in the late last year. However, there has been less training and more McDonald's. After school, he usually grabs a Fanta and games for several hours. But not today. Samuel stands in front of the mirror in the hallway at home on Nøtterøy in Vestfold, just a place in Norway. He has taken off his t-shirt with his mobile phone. He snaps pictures of the boy's body. He snaps pictures of the boy's body, it sounds like. Okay. He snaps pictures of his body is what it should have been. It sounds like someone else was taking pictures of him. Yeah. Lately has been told several times that he is fat, sometimes at school, but mostly when he's in gaming with others or posting videos on his YouTube channel. Something may have been nonsense, but Samuel knows that it still hits. Wait. He feels that it still hits him, not knows. And I agree. I don't think NRK should have posted this. This is, in my opinion, really fucking bad of that journalist to even post this picture of a 13-year-old kid. The fuck are they doing? Photo private? Yeah, they just probably took it. So we can skip his story. He tried to tighten his muscle, all he sees in the mirror is a flappy stomach and some fishbowl arms. Samuel decides to do something. None of the girls in class would want a fat boy, he thinks. He searches for the word six-pack in social media. Musclemen quickly appear, who have good news. It's going to last just 10 minutes every day, max 30 days to get ripped. Okay, we're not presenting that kind of information anyway, but after 30 days, Samuel does not have a six-pack on his stomach. He tries some more. This is some strawman Andy journalism. This is typical Norwegian journalism. This is everything you can get. And okay, using clickbait, I would like articles like this, have links to prove what they write. It's scary how many swallows up the mainstream rights with little to no evidence or proof, but mental health is a big issue with in all ages now. I know. I agree. And this is what I don't want, right? This is why I don't want to... When those young boys are sending me messages, I'm like, I'm taking some steps back. Blame his parents? I agree you should blame the parents. Shad kid wanting to improve? Do you like Andrew Tate? I feel like I've missed a lot there. No. But he's a fucking internet clown, Cartero. People take him too serious. He's doing it for attention and money, right? I take him as any other clown on the internet that makes some content. And he is doing the edgy content to make people upset. And it worked, right? It's not like to get advice about health, the fucking parents. Can you get nutritionists to talk about general health? Maybe we can hire one for a session. Since it's from a doctor and not the journalist who have to go against local health advice. We could probably get someone to speak out without paying them as well. There's probably a lot that would want to help. Someone who's not crazy, yeah. Samuel becomes Samuel. What does this mean? In recent years, several people have pointed out that the algorithms in social media have become better at picking up and reinforcing such longings as Samuel has, especially on TikTok, which according to the Norwegian Media Authority is the platform that increasingly the most among children and young people in Norway. The world's most downloaded app has received criticism for serving unhealthy amounts of, for example, exercise, diet tips and depressive content. The latest year, the Chinese company that owns TikTok promised to work to avoid such rabbit holes. Okay, we can skip a little bit. The strong community. It is early afternoon, school is over for most 13-year-olds, and the robot Samuel is swiping TikTok. He sees a goose running, some food, more animals, and Sandra Ling as a jogger. Currently, it's 0% muscle. Okay, it is some. For a couple of hours, less than 4% of what he sees about exercise and diet to build muscle. But overnight, something happened. The next morning, only a few minutes pass before the first gym bro appears. A gym bro is a muscular man, lives a life characterized by heavy weights and the pursuit of an ever larger body. Despite the fact that Samuel has only been swiping for a short time, it is clear that TikTok is on the track of what he longs for. The algorithm are now afraid to indulge in increasingly extreme content. It's not afraid. Soon it will be toasted protein shakes. Adult muscle men are called daddy, papa, or boss. The meals are broken down into how many grams of protein, carbohydrates, and fat they contain. There is ever a broad-shouldered man who talks about these three safest anabolic steroids to use. Only been swiping around for 3 hours in total. Nevertheless, now at least every second video is about bodybuilding muscle. Finally, the robot traps one of the videos and comments. Tips for a 13-year-old who wants to build muscle. This article is straight up from presentation of the 8th grade. No straight up knowledge, no. He's just talking about the story of this guy. Do you see my point? This is Norwegian media. NRK can now document that 519 users write in Norwegian and state that they are between 9 and 14 years old. The vast majority are boys. In total, the children have left almost 4,500 comments. Probably the numbers are much higher. Few people state their age when they comment. But what are the children asking the muscle men about? Hello boss, I'm 12 years old. I use like 3 kilos on each arm. Oh fuck, the headset turned off because there's no sound. How many reps should I do to get big biceps? Some tips for slightly fat 9-year-old who wants to lose some fat around the stomach and chest. Please reply to the video. How can you look thin when you are 11 years old? This is a parent's issue. The thing is, in Norway, probably Sweden as well, nothing is a parent's issue. Everything is the state's issue. They should censor, they should remove, because no one should do anything themselves. It should be different, but the population should be protected against themselves in a way. You're young and don't care about. All the Norwegian gym influencers I know of all say the same. If you're young, then you don't care about the calories. I kinda agree, but calories is the thing. I agree and disagree at the same time. You know why? Because knowing how calories work is the fucking best tool in this world to not get extremely obese and to know what you're eating. See some numbers, but at the same time focusing on it too much. It's easy for kids to overdo things, to be too extreme. They don't know how they should use this knowledge. Obsessed, yes. But at the same time, they should probably know how it works. Shouldn't they? Even if they're young? Because the days where you could just eat a slice of bread with some fucking cheese on, those days, I feel like they're over. And that's the problem. Government exists to protect the rights to citizens, not to be their parents. I agree with you. Thought about these things when I was a kid because I moved my ass and was active, skinny as F. Yeah, and it wasn't a McDonald's on every street corner to make you fat anyway. There has always been kids with the issue like this. Not changed since I was a kid in the 80s. However, social media has created more pressure on the young today. I 100% agree. I'm blaming McDonald's. Just don't eat the trash. I'm not blaming McDonald's itself. But how many parents today compare... When I was a kid growing up in Hallegdal, there wasn't any fast food... Even close. Bokken ruser Jønban from Twitch. Be careful this time. Kids look up to the heroes, Knut Arnold's, the parents' job to make them. Don't focus on body when 9 years old. I 100% agree, but... Something. The Norwegian state and parents and everyone has to realize is this. Social media is here to stay. This content is here to stay. You can say it to all Norwegian influencers, make a fucking law that you can't promote this. They can even put up prison as a punishment, and it won't do anything because it's not going to happen in the rest of the world. It's not going to happen anywhere else in the world than up here in our socialist fucking countries. And it might get worse, yes. Teach parents how to raise a child and it will be solved. There's also a factor, Knut. People just want to sit on their ass and be comfortable these days, not move their body. Yes. It's always... Why do you think those videos like he was watching? Six-pack in 30 days. Why do you think that is popular? Because people are think it's 30 days to a six-pack looking like a fucking Greek god. I don't want to comment on that. I will be cancelled. Let's just skip that topic for now. Six-packs are built in the kitchen, not in the gym anyway. True. Muscle, muscle, muscle. Samuel is at the start of the day 3 and he has swiped for a total of 5 hours. The first day he watched almost no muscle videos the other day. Every other video was about it. Now TikTok algorithm is serving up muscle men on a convoy belt. Over 90% of the content is about getting bigger and stronger. Good point you're bringing up here. 5 hours on TikTok and problem is muscle man. Good point you're bringing up. How long does it start banning social media in general because parents can't teach kids good habits? When I was a kid, there was an 18-year age limit on a lot of things, and it was for a reason. The king of Norwegian muscle, TikTok. Kristoffer Bjørndal from Bergen has around 50 million plays on his TikTok videos. In the comments, people do not hesitate to call him boss or the king. This is just bullshit viewers are saying because they like his content. Oh my god, so stupid. He's also the one who receives the... by far most comments from Norwegian children, according to NRK survey. In the basement flat outside the city center, the 26-year-old is getting ready to record the first video of the day. He switches on a small camera light and settles in with his mobile phone in hand. He looks straight into the lens, smiles slightly and presses record. Oh my, Bjørnal admits that at first he did not think about the fact that his followers could be children. I noticed very well that there was many young people who have come into this. It's almost scary. If I say something, many people do what I say without checking other sources, he says. A few hours later, he's standing and posing at the local gym. The black room has mirrors on all sides. Bjørndal is wearing shorts. It smells of rubber, steel and sweat. In the spring, he become Norway champion in men's physique, a kind of bodybuilding competition, but simply it means getting the fine body with a narrow waist and broad shoulders. This is the body the children in his comment section dream of. Although Bjørnar usually answers that they have to train because it's fun and not compare themselves to adults, he sees what he does as two sides. For some, It will create body pressure that I show my body when I compete, while for others it will provide motivation. So as a sports scientist and a teacher and academy trains personal trainers. Yeah. Cycle of the gym, bro. The bigger you get, the smaller you feel. The smaller you feel, the harder you lift. The harder you lift, the bigger you get. This is what we need to avoid. Imagine if Knut was in this article, it would have been said, bald, clueless and fat boy, TikToker Knut has millions of views, people comment bald and clueless on every video. They're starting to ban TikTok for government workers. Texas bans TikTok on government devices. Oh, but that's okay. Like on banning, they're just banning them on the devices that belongs to the government. If it collects information, I feel like that is okay. When, where, and how they conduct internet activity and offers a show to... Yeah, and this article, Everett, proves exactly what you're saying. I have to say, when we were kids, this wasn't seen as a problem. Because we were training hard at the gym from the age of 16, at least. We were lifting weights at school when we were 13. And it was never seen as a problem. Because we didn't have social media. Do you know what? Why? Because the focus was on lifting weights and having fun. It's better getting into weightlifting at 13 than 18, because in 13 you're still developing in a better frame than if you work out at 18, your body starts being fully developed. Now people focus more on others and compare themselves, just like getting a tattoo to impress his neighbor. Yes, Tarim Schilling, I agree with you. And do you remember? Again, I'm going back to what I said yesterday. The best life advice and the advice they should have wrote here is, and they need to know the fucking hard truth. You will never look like the guy on the internet. The guy you're looking at the internet, you will never look like him. Just say it straight up. You will always look like yourself. You can look at this guy. No, Voa, did you won't look like him? It's all genetics. Yeah, it's you can better yourself, but you won't look like that guy on the internet. But can you lifting weights at a young age stuns your growth? Yeah, that's so much fake. No, Knut, I am the guy on the internet. Yeah, you can be that guy.